at 4:15 Pacific Coast time, I experienced a shift. June 30th, 2013, 4:15, West Coast US time, Pacific time zone. I was taking a rest, and it was in just semi-sleep, and suddenly in my solar plexus area, sort of maybe just below the solar plexus area, but in maybe this a subtler body than my physical body, something suddenly went shifted like that. And then suddenly all my thoughts changed. The order of my thoughts changed. I could feel a rearranging of all my thoughts. All thought patterns changed. And then I was able to see in my mind's eye easily on a cosmic scale, like galaxy, like a whole galaxy, a spiral galaxy. I was able to just look and see an entire like spiral galaxy in my mind. And then it was as if all these like light panels began assembling, getting brighter and brighter and brighter and brighter and brighter, for all, like solar panels, like light panels were somehow being assembled throughout my whole being, as it were. It was subtle, but I was like, whoa, this something's going on here. Something's really just took place. Like, bing, like that, like a lock just suddenly opened up. So something absolutely happened June 30th, 2013, as I was told, prepare for something to very, very significant to happen. And what is that? The bug is back. The bug is back from last night. So anyway, here we go. As I was told, the last part of June would be the most important pivotal turning point. And it certainly has, hasn't it been? That is, it was accurate. It was given very accurate information. We literally have just the most colossal redefinition of everything. And just the whole world has suddenly been pivoted and turned upside down, as it were, and the mood of people now is just, we find out that, you know, that all this deception has been taking place, the spying everywhere. We find out so many things are going on right this time, and so the underpinnings of civilization, the rug's been pulled out from under us at the end of June. We don't trust our government anymore. People really just don't trust anything anymore. The very foundation of civilization, the family, has been redefined. People are just saying, what is going on? What is going on, really? And it's deep-seated. It is this collapse is coming. So we see the enormous unrest in Brazil, now the enormous unrest in Egypt, just a sense of global distrust now, global distrust, and scandal after scandal, and it's just the whole thing is just coming down as the advice given to me in a dream, and I was told around June 30th, there's going to be you'll experience. The boost will begin, some sort of boost will begin. It did, 4:15 Pacific Standard Time. Around 4:15, I was dozing. And it was noticeable. My thoughts, I just noticed that suddenly, as if all my thoughts, that the sequence of my thinking was suddenly rearranged. Everything was like subtly and beautifully rearranged into a different way of ordering my thoughts, as it were, and it hasn't had any effect on my functioning at all. This was like a subtle thing, Indeed. This reminds me of August 18th, 1999, which was the beginning of the collapse, where the dimensional barriers suddenly broke down and the fourth dimensional belief systems and mindset had unimpeded access to this planet at that time, and that gave rise to this modern culture we have now of the internet took off from that point. And the high technology, the social media, the smartphones, everything we have now, really the full push came in after August 18th, 1999. And I experienced at that time an expansion of my awareness into other realms. I saw a huge planet of populated by people who worship gadgets, totally obsessed with gadgets. The whole planet was completely monitored. Every last thing involved metering and monitoring and gadgets. And even kids were inventing all sorts of little gadgets, and they grew up making little mechanized gadgets and various high-tech stuff, and the planet was obsessed. You go outside and there were little robots going along. Kids had these little, you know, they'd be flying little things and doing little things. The whole planet was like that, and I felt like my spirit was dying. It was the most terrible experience. And it's that mindset has come into the world now, the gadget-based mindset. It used to be that everybody had, I remember, Swiss Army knives. And, you know, we could just do about anything with Swiss Army knives. Corkscrew, saw, file, all sorts of knives, bottle openers. I mean, everybody had one, knew how to use a Swiss Army knife, and we could do all sorts of stuff, practical things. Now everybody has the smartphones. What can you really do with a smartphone? Play games? I don't know, tweet? GPS, it's useful, but you know, what can you do practically? Like a Swiss Army knife, you can actually. We did all sorts of stuff with Swiss Army knives. We were trained in scouting, etc., how to function practically. But today's generation doesn't have a clue how to function practically. All they know is what the smartphone can do. That's about it. So who's going to do the work? For example, so. We are in a situation now as a planet with the tinderbox is ready to ignite. The trust has been broken down around the world. And it's amazing that we were tipped off about this being the time when we would have to get ready for and receive this boost, as I say, accept the Holy Spirit's training program. That is it, which exclusively deals with the continuity problem, which is the only problem we really have. Without this continuity problem, we would drop this world like that. Everybody would just drop it like that. Be instant. Nobody wants this ridiculous farce we call planet Earth. And we have to appeal more and more and more to the goofy puppy-likeness of youth. You know, think, oh yeah, we're having so much fun here. No, that's just biological mechanisms, you know, sorting themselves out, etc. It seems wonderful, but check in with the people later on and see how happy they are. And so we have to use it more and more and more and more, trying to tell ourselves, oh, the life is so wonderful, so fun, so much fun. It's not fun at all. So, going forward, from this point, I don't have any information as to what's going to happen next. I do know that there is something shifted. I experienced a shift, a significant shift. Never experienced that before. So something is likely to take place. And again, I just have to own it. And it's the price I have to pay. If people, you know, bug me or something, that's just the price I have to pay for a while. I've had that going on for quite some time. I walk into a store and people are talking, I just stop talking, they start staring. And I just like, what are they staring at? I have no idea. I say, it's weird. It's kind of like that. I don't know. But So maybe there's something going on in the subtle body, you know, the subtle body's being rearranged, and somehow they're picking that up subliminally, something. It's not a hostile stare, it's just kind of like, ah, huh, what's that? And you're just like, huh, I don't know. 122 in Palm Springs today. I wanted to be there. I wanted to go down to Palm Springs this weekend. I haven't been there for 3 years. 122, I would have loved it. Loved it, 122, that's fantastic. But alas, wasn't able to do it. A little too hot to play golf, though, I think. I think I'm not. Maybe early morning. Get in by 9 o'clock. Might be okay. 129.9 in Death Valley. That would have been great to be there as well. Melt the glue on your shoes. Shoes would probably fall apart on you. So hot. So we're in this incredible heat wave right now. At the very same time, this incredible heat wave. This incredible realization of the world, that the world's been spied upon, and there's more going on than we can imagine, and it's been betrayal of trust, and then more. They had an article on surveillance, of local surveillance, of the police are surveillance on everybody, cameras everywhere, automatic license plate readers, so many ways we're being spied on continuously. We live in a Stasi-like surveillance and spy state, and it's going to become way worse beyond anything we can imagine, really, at this point. And you know, what can you do? You just say, I think it's time to make the shift. It's time to make the shift. So it seems as though we are in the time when the shift is going to take place. What is the shift? I don't know exactly what the shift is. There are a lot of people have chimed in over the years about this, about some kind of shift coming. Whether the Andromedans will take people in spaceships to another planet, or, you know, this evacuation to somehow big evacuation from the Starfleet or something. And all these various talks about this, ascension, the rapture, all these things, pre-trib, et cetera. There is something coming. There is something coming. And not a moment too soon, because the world's coming unglued. In the Bible, it talks about an evil and adulterous generation that will come onto this planet at the end times, and that will be the sign. We will know that this is it. This is when the shift happens. And I would say that the times fit that description really well, really well. The youth are very angry, and they hate the older generation, and they think they have it all, and they're gonna have nothing, and it's a mess. It's really a mess. It's the massive debt that hangs over our heads, and it goes on and on and on and on. The redefinition of everything, the healthcare system being redefined. They continuously are redefining things so fast that, like, the older folks just can't even keep up with it. It's just, if you want to get into a negative mindset about what's happening, it's easy, because there's so much. And so the shift is upon us. It seems as though something is now going to happen. Parting of the ways, a wheat from the chaff. Those who there was a reading today in church letter, St. Paul's letter to the Galatians, something like 5:2-17 or something like that, about how you have to accept the Spirit and what the Spirit tells you is right, and forsake the flesh, because he said that what Spirit wants for us and what flesh wants for us are completely at odds with one another. Okay, and if you accept what the Spirit tells you, you're not going to like it. I mean, the flesh is not going to like it at all. So it requires you to accept something that's hard to accept. The flesh will war against it. That is very true. And also it's said that, not in that passage, some other one, is that if you, it's John, what is it, John something, John 17 or something, that if you, oh, the first John, the letter of John, 1 John something, 17 or something, 2:17, 1 John, that if you love the flesh, then you don't love God. God is not with you. You're not with God at all. And you cannot love both flesh and God. It's impossible. And so there are these very strong statements that talk about how the kingdom of the flesh, the desires of the flesh, all of that is at war with Spirit. And what Spirit wants for us, what the Holy Spirit wants for us is to accept its training program to overcome the continuity problem, so we can realize that we really never left reality and all is well, and we can never die, so there's no need to even pursue that. That's what the Holy Spirit wants for us. And what mind is presenting to us is a training program to try to learn how to die. That's the flesh. That's called the flesh. And that leads us into all these horrible predicaments and as training exercises. So where's the world at right now? Of course it's at favoring the mind's presentation. By far and away it's favoring the mind's presentation. It's favoring the flesh now. Didn't used to be that way. Did not used to be that way. And go back in earlier times, people were very strict. Very strict. They had very strict standards. Very strict standards. They said, you don't cross this line, because then you're following the flesh, which is true. And people have been trampling those lines and more until they've just leveled them, bulldozed them down, and says, now, anything goes. That they're celebrating the victory of the flesh over the Holy Spirit, as it were. And which is absolute folly. It is absolute disaster. So, of course, the Holy Spirit will, at this time, do something. It will do something. It will not allow us to backslide too far. At some point, it will say enough's enough. And we need to, those who are serious need protection. They need shielding. They need shielding from this world. What's going on in this world is iniquity to an unbelievable extent. An unbelievable extent. We could go on and on and on about that. So, but the Holy Spirit will do something. And it may involve, who knows what it's going to involve. I don't know. Is it subtle? Is it overt? Is it both? But definitely now, again, the second half of this year is going to be very great for those who have decided they want to part ways with the advice of the flesh. In other words, part ways with mind's training program, which is designed to teach spirit how to die to what it is, which is impossible, but which is what spirit desires to learn, because then it thinks it can be prime creator, greater than God. So mind is spinning this terrible training program and telling us how great it is, how blessed we are, how fortunate we are to have this training program. And it's the key to happiness and the perfect happiness and glory and all of this stuff. And God is 100% behind it, and on this mind is telling us these lies, continually lying to us. Well, those who decided to part ways with lies will have their Holy Spirit training program. And I expect this training program to begin. We're going to be introduced to it in some way now. Absolutely introduced to it in some way. The Holy Spirit asked me to not do a few things. He says, to wait until after the 30th before you do anything. And I said, okay, you got it. Because the mind is trying to aggrandize its training program and give some sort of spiritual authority to it. And it's very tricky about this, how it does this. It tried to get me to do certain things that it could use to try to legitimize its training program at this point. And so I said, no, I'm going to wait. Holy Spirit wants me to wait. Don't do it yet. Don't do this. It just wait and see how things go after June 30th. So I've heeded that and backed off some stuff. things have shifted in the world, haven't they? Fundamentally. Fundamentally shifting. Things have shifted. Those who are loyal to the flesh are now very, very, well, on the warpath, you might say. Across the board, all over the world, in many, many different ways. The Bible says, drunk on the blood of the saints. The whore of Babylon, her army is now drunk on the blood of the saints and is going berserk with bloodlust. They say, we've got the Holy Spirit on the run. Let's just, you know, pounce and go all in a frenzy, that kind of thing. And the Holy Spirit won't let that happen. If whatever needs to happen will happen. And certainly, there will be the appropriate shifts taking place. And again, overcoming your valuing of this world is essential. If you value this world, how can you undertake the Holy Spirit's training program that helps you see, drop all the definitions, which is the world. The world is just a definition, actually. Just a definition. So we are now... Congratulations, everybody. We're in the most momentous times now. The second half of 2013 is the most momentous time that we have had up to this date, by far and away. From this day forward, who knows? All bets are off at this point. I mean, just if you just lie down for a nap and suddenly something pops and you shift and just like that, all bets are off. All bets are off right now. Truly, all bets are off, which is a great thing. It's great for us because we finally say, hey, you know what? This world is not looking appealing at all at this point. We're ready for a different training program. This training program has lost me. It's lost me. This world has absolutely lost me, 100%. So I'm ready for a new training program. I'm absolutely ready for it. Don't really have any allegiance to this world or attachment. Our love for it, any feeling like that, it's lost me, gone with the wind. It's no longer, I don't even think of it as suitable for anything. So, ready for a shift, a new training program. And this one will lead to dropping all definitions eventually and experiencing the true glory of reality, which is, we cannot even begin to explain it, so we won't even try. So again, well done everyone who's made it to this point. Fabulous, tremendous job that we're still able to function like this, and we haven't collapsed ourselves, haven't got downcast. It's been an incredible push for me and for here on this channel, and I feel the information I've given is accurate. The talking about the end of June and the extreme importance of that and then reaching this date turns out, I believe, to be very, very accurate. We've had the most momentous 2 weeks, I think, in history, really, in many, many ways. It's just the we're just looking up and say, oh here comes, the whole thing is coming down. And you know, who knows what can happen next, as again, it's being orchestrated by mind, so mind will play its cards one after the other. So, you know, a surprise every day. But again, we are now in the time of the time of the blessing, where we will begin to somehow experience some shifts and something truly enormous, more enormously positive will happen. This array of light panels that I was sort of experiencing, my whole being was arraying these light panels to be emitting light or something. And I was like, ah, wow. I said, okay. I said, yeah, go ahead. I don't mind. It's time for that. It's time. Whatever. Let it rip. Let it go. It's time. So we are now at this time. So I'm completely positive right now. Very up. Not down at all. Not downcast at all. Very upbeat. And feeling very confident about the future right now, that the best is most certainly about to arrive for us, and truly momentous, great, great times for us, absolutely great times. So just feel that, expect it, and pull yourself out of any despondency of the effort of will and say, hey, I hung in here this long just for these times right now. So I'm just going to be sky high and enjoy the ride. So absolutely, everyone, enjoy the ride. That's it.